Hi guys, welcome back to Hobby Plus. Today I am showing you a original Smps circuit. You can make this circuit for yourself and it is really working beautifully. Output voltage is 27 and 17. That is absolutely depend on the transformer, on this transformer. That is very simple and easy, but there is a IC that is also a inbuilt MOSFET there. There is a inbuilt MOSFET. Another two pin in here. One is UV, that means it is under voltage sensor pin, and another is BP, that means bypass or multifunction. Here is a little tricks. You put your AC through 4.4 meg, that is 2.2 meg, and that is also, so you get 4.4 meg. After that, 1.5 meg are coupled with BP, bypass or multifunction pin. If you change this value, your frequency will be changed, and that is the coupling optocoupler, you know, that is absolutely used for feedback. And there is the third coil which is define the voltage for bypass or multifunction pin. It is a very simple and easy way to design, but there is a different part, that is freewheel diode. You see that after you get your voltage from output of the transformer, there is a diode that is also a Schottky diode or high frequency diode. After that, here is a coil, both in both line, that is one is 27 volt and another is 17 volt, that is some other appliances. You can make this according to your need. There is a ground pin, and little tricks are there. Here is the ground pin. See that? Now you can see that clearly. And after that, they put a high voltage capacitor. That is a high voltage capacitor. Actually, this value is 2.2 kilofarad. It is a very small value, you know, but it is also used for suppressing the noise from the output. Now, I describe something, I want to say something about this input circuit. There is a ground pin, that means earthing pin. There is a varistor. You know what is the purpose of this varistor. Here is a fuse and here is a resistance. After that, that is a AC noise suppression coil, also you can call choke coil. Both are in same direction. See that? Both of them in same direction. Here is a resistance. This value is too much high. So it is used for suppress another noise. If this coil cannot suppress this, then the resistance can do this. That is your X-type capacitor. That is suppress your noise again, and you get better performance for that. Here is a Y-type, no, sorry, that is your X-type, okay. It is a Y-type capacitor which is connected from phase to ground, I mean earth, and from neutral to earth. That is your ground. It is not for here, it is here. That is your ground pin. You get a H bridge rectifier, and this resistance is high value resistance, definitely. This is called breeder resistance. That is your filter capacitor. Obviously, when you put here 220 volt AC, then you have to put here 450 volt DC cap. According to your load, you can decide the value. I think you know. If your load is suppose 20 watt, then you have to put here 47 microfarad. That means load into 2 plus, that is the thumb rule. And you also know one thing, if you put here a high voltage capacitor, that means there is a coil. So low frequency can pass through this cap, but high frequency can't. So you have to another capacitor here, which is also 450 volt or 600 volt or 630 volt, but value is 1.1 microfarad or lower, 0.01. That means the high frequency through this capacitor to ground, pass through this capacitor, that is your capacitor, you know, your high frequency pass through this capacitor and low frequency pass through this capacitor. So you get a good and better DC output line. I always tell DC output line. You think, what is the meaning of that? Actually, DC is a line. We always need that. So you, when you make a DC line, then you have to put better capacitor to filter the AC. After that, here is a passive snapper using here, and after transformer, supply goes to directly IC, then source to ground. I tell everything and you can do this, but I have to tell one thing again, that is your Y-type capacitor, both of them. One suppressed the spike from the primary section, another suppressed the spike from your output section, secondary section. That's why it is very important to use in your SMPS. It is very simple and easy circuit. You can make it. If you think, where I get my PCB, where I get, how can I design this, so many questions if you have, then you can tell me. I can provide you a PCB, because you know I designed that. I think you understand everything, but you never forget this free will diode. Actually, I have to say something about free will diode. It is important. When your coil, when your transformer working, now it is on, then DC, then you get DC here. After that, DC filter here and goes to the output. And when this supply goes to off, that means power cannot goes to through this coil. So through the load back to the ground, mind it, after that through this diode back to the coil, because that is your negative point, that is your high point. In that moment, when this diode is off, in that moment, that is your low point, that is your minus point, and that is your plus point. I mean, that is plus and that is minus. So your power should be go back to minus for neutralize the coil and discharge the coil also. So look at this, that is one flywheel diode, free wheel diode, and that is one that is used for this coil and that is used for this coil, but both coil you can put in a same physical inductor. You can use here double E core and make this coil, no problem at all. And look at this, here is a SCR which is control the output voltage and through feedback the IC, that is your feedback control. I mean, that is your feedback control, which is controlled by the TL431, that is SCR, you know that. And that is a simple coupling. You can do this, and I am sure you can get a good power supply for your work. Thank you very much. We meet again with a new video and new topic.